Hi everyone, welcome to Miraculous Microbes. I am Dr. Avinodhini. Today I would like to discuss about nitrogen fixation. Let's get started. Nitrogen fixation. There are two types of nitrogen fixation. First one is the physiological nitrogen fixation. Second is the biological nitrogen fixation. Apart from carbon, hydrogen and oxygen, nitrogen is one of the most prevalent essential macro element in the living organism. Plants need nitrogen to build the amino acid, proteins, nucleic acid, cytochromes, chlorophylls, alkaloids, phytohormones and many of the vitamins. The plant compete with microbes for limited nitrogen content available in the soil. Plant mainly absorb the nitrogen in the form of the nitrate or ammonium ions from the soil. The nitrate is the most abundant in well-oxygenated, non-acidic soil, while ammonium is predominant in acidic or waterlogged soils. The other source of available soil nitrogen may be amino acid from decaying organic matter, animal excreta, and chemical fertilizer that can be absorbed directly by the plants. Nitrogen is obtained by the plants mainly from the atmosphere. It occurs as the free diatomic molecules in the air. It is highly inert gas that cannot be used directly by the higher plants and therefore has to be fixed. The phenomenon of the conversion of free nitrogen into nitrogenous compounds is called as the nitrogen fixation. Nitrogen fixation is carried out by physicochemical and biological means. About 10% of the natural nitrogen fixation takes place by physicochemical methods and 90% by biological methods. First type of nitrogen fixation is physical nitrogen fixation. In that, two type of the nitrogen fixations are there, that is natural nitrogen fixation and industrial nitrogen fixation. First we see the natural nitrogen fixation. Under the influence of lightning, that is the electrical discharge in the clouds and thunder, nitrogen and oxygen of the air react to form the nitric oxide, that is NO. This nitric oxides are again oxidized with oxygen to form nitrogen peroxide, that is the NO2. During the rain, nitrogen peroxide combines with the rainwater to form nitrous acid and nitric acid, that is NHO2 and NHO3 respectively. This acid falls on the soil along with the rainwater and react with the alkaline radicals to form the water-soluble nitrates NO3- and nitrates NO2-. These nitrates are soluble in water and are directly absorbed by the root of the plants. Next is the industrial nitrogen fixation. Ammonium is produced industrially by direct combination of nitrogen with hydrogen at high temperature and pressure. Later, it was converted into fertilizer like urea. Second type of nitrogen fixation is the biological nitrogen fixation. The conversion of atmospheric nitrogen into nitrogenous compounds through the agency of the living organism is called the biological nitrogen fixation. The process is carried out by two main types of the microorganism, those which live near close symbiotic association with other plants and those which are free living or non-symbiotic organisms. Biological nitrogen fixation is a process whereby atmospheric nitrogen is reduced to ammonia in the presence of nitrogenase. Nitrogenase is a biological catalyst found naturally only in a certain microorganism like symbiotic rhizobium and Frankia and free living organism like Azospirillum, Azotobacter and blue green algae. Nearly 80% of Earth atmosphere contains nitrogen in the form of highly inert dinitrogen, which most plants cannot utilize as such. The atmospheric nitrogen, that is N2, consists of two nitrogen atoms like linked by triple covalent bond. The phenomenon of the reduction of inert gaseous dinitrogen into ammonia, that is NH3, through the agency of the some microorganism, so it can be made available to plants, is called the biological nitrogen fixation or otherwise called as the diazotrophy. Nitrogen fixes. Among the earth organism, only some prokaryotic like bacteria and cyanobacteria can fix the atmospheric nitrogen. They are called as the nitrogen fixers or diazotrophs. They fix about 95% of the total global nitrogen fixed annually by natural process. Diazotropes may be asymbiotic, that is a free living, or symbiotic as given below. First type is the free living nitrogen fixing bacteria, Azotobacter bagianica and Clostridium or saprophytic bacteria that perform the nitrogen fixation. Second is the D-sulfur vibrio, is a chemotropic nitrogen fixing bacterium, Rhodopseudomonas, Rhodospirillum and Chromatium or nitrogen fixing photoautotropic bacteria. Second type is the free-living nitrogen-fixing cyanobacteria. Many free-living blue-green algae, that is cyanobacteria, perform the nitrogen fixation, example Anabina and Nastoc. They are important ecologically as they live near waterlogged soils where denitrifying bacteria can be active. Third type is the symbiotic nitrogen-fixing cyanobacteria. Anabina and Nastoc, a species, a common symbiotics in the lichens, Anthroceros azaleo, or in the cycad roots. Fourth type is the symbiotic nitrogen-fixing bacteria. Rhizobium is a aerobic, gram-negative nitrogen-fixing bacterial symbionts of the papilionaceous roots. Sesbania rostrata has rhizobium in the root nodules and aerorhizobium in the stem nodules. Frankia is a symbiont in the root nodules of many non-leguminous plants like alnus. Xanthomonas and Mycobacterium occur as a symbionts in the leaves of some members of families Rubaceae. Several species of rhizobium live in the soil but are unable to fix the nitrogen by themselves. Symbiotic nitrogen fixation. Both rhizobium and Frankia are exist as a free living and the symbionts in the soil, but symbionts only can able to fix the atmospheric nitrogen. Root nodule formation is the first step in the symbiotic nitrogen fixation. Host specificity, variety of the microorganism present in the rhizosphere of the plant root, that is the immediate vicinity to the plant roots. The roots of the leguminous plant secretes a group of the chemical attractants like flavonoids and betanines. The response to these chemical attractants, specific rhizobial cells migrate towards the root hair and produce the knot factor, that is the nodulation. The knot factor found on the bacterial surface bind to the lectin proteins present on the surface of root hairs. This lectin knot factor interaction induces growth and curling of the root hairs around the rhizobia. At these regions, wall degrades in response to knot factor and rhizobia enters the root hair invagination of plasma membrane called infection thread. This infection thread filled with dividing rhizobia elongates through the root hair and later branched to reach different cortical cells. The rhizobia are released into cortical cell either single or in groups enclosed by a membrane. The rhizobium stop dividing, lose the cell wall and become nitrogen fixing cell and lead the bacteroids. The membrane surrounding the bacteroids is called as the peribacterioid membrane. The infected cortical cell divide to form the nodules. Next step is the mechanism of nitrogen fixation. The nodule serves as a site for nitrogen fixation. It contains all necessary biochemicals such as the enzyme complex called nitrogenase and leg hemoglobin, which is otherwise called as leguminous hemoglobin. The nitrogenase has two components, that is MOFE protein, molybdenferredoxin, and FE protein, azoferredoxin. The nitrogenase catalyzes the conversion of the atmospheric dinitrogen to ammonia. Ammonia is the first stable product of the nitrogen fixation. The nitrogenase is the extremely sensitive to oxygen. To protect these enzymes, nodule contains oxygen scavenger called leg hemoglobin, that is simply called as LB, which is reddish pink pigment. There are two views about the location of the leg hemoglobin, that is either located outside the peribacterioid membrane or located in between the bacteroids. During the nitrogen fixation, the free dinitrogen first bound to MOFE protein and is not released until completely reduced to ammonia. The reduction of dinitrogen is a stepwise reaction in which many intermediates are formed to form ammonia, that is NH3, which is protonated at physiological pH to form NH4+, that is ammonium. In this process, ferredoxin serves as an electron donor to Fe protein, which in turn hydrolyze ATP and reduce MoFe protein. The MoFe protein is turn reduce the substrate nitrogen. The electron and ATP are provided by photosynthesis and respiration of the host cell. Assimilation of ammonia. Ammonia produced by nitrogenase is immediately protonated to form ammonium ion, that is NH4+, which is toxic to plants, so it is rapidly used near the site of generation to the synthesis of the amino acid. The amino acid synthesis takes place by three methods, that is reductive amination, catalytic amination and transamination. First is the reductive amination. In this process, glutamate dehydrogenase, that is GDH, catalyzes the synthesis of glutamic acid. Next is the catalytic amination. This is two-step process catalyzed by glutamine synthetase, which is GS, and glutamate synthetase, which is glutamine 2-oxyglutarate aminotransferase or GOGAT. Out of two glutamates produced, one returned to GS while other is exported to the plant. Third step is the transamination. Glutamate or glutamic acid is a main amino acid from which other amino acids are derived through transamination. The enzyme aminotransferases catalyze all such reactions. Transamination involves the transfer of amino group from one amino acid to keto group of keto acids. Example, glutamate combined with oxaloacetate forms the aspartate plus 2-oxyglutarate. In nitrogen fixing plant, the fixed nitrogen is exported in the form of amides and uridates from the nodules to other plant parts via xylem. Amides are formed from two amino acids, namely glutamic acid and aspartic acid, by replacing OH part by another NH2- radicals. Thus, amides contain more nitrogen than amino acid and are structural part of the most protein. Next is the nitrate assimilation. Nitrate cannot be utilized by plant as such. It first reduced to ammonia before being incorporated into organic compounds. The reduction of nitrate occurs in two steps. First step is the reduction of nitrate to nitrite. It is carried out by inducible enzyme nitrate reductase. This enzyme is the molybdo flavor protein. It requires the reduced coenzyme like NADH or NADPH for its activity. It is brought in contact with nitrate by FAD or FMN. Next step is the reduction of nitrate. It is carried out by the enzyme nitrate reductase. The enzyme is the metalloflavo protein which contains copper and iron. It occurs inside the chloroplast in the leaf cell and the leucoplast of other cells. The nitrate reductase requires reduced power. It is NADPH and NADH. Reduction process also require ferredoxin, which occur in green tissues of the higher plants. It is presumed that in higher plants, either nitrite or translocated to leaf cell or some other electron donors operates in unilluminated cells. The product of nitrate reduction is the ammonia. Ammonia thus produced combines with organic acid to produce the amino acids. Amino acid form the protein by the process of their translation. Thank you. I hope this video gives you enough idea about the nitrogen fixation. I will catch you at the next video related to the microbiology.